Hello. Come right on in. You're at Father Fish. Nice to have you with us.
Every 3 or 4 weeks.
Okay.
I do like 50% water change.
Oh, you're doing, but you're doing 50. Okay. You could do every week and do 10.
Yeah. But most of mine, when I do them, I'll do more, you know, than what Father Fish was just recommending. But I do have well water, and the tanks are.
Are you like sucking stuff out or just taking it out, adding it in?
I just throw a siphon in. I don't really. If there's a couple spots, I'll just hit them quickly. But I pretty much just take the water out and add it back in. I don't worry about mulm in my breeding tanks or anything like that. They are super messy. But they're not, they're not for me just to look at and think, oh, they're just so pretty. You know, I have that, on a couple tanks, and then my other tanks are more utilitarian, just for being to.
Sorry.
But that's how I do it. So we all do different things.
That's good. Sounds good. I just was curious. That's all.
Yeah.
Want to know more.
I just fly around the house.
I'm kind of like you. I'm between you and Mary.
Big city
betta. And I do what she does.
Big city bettas talking about using aloe with bettas. She says it will dissolve if you have to kind of beat it into the water. But tea tree oil, she recommends tea tree oil for the very reason Cassie B. Described, that it coats the labyrinth and the fish can suffocate.
You can't use tea tree oil, she said.
That's what she's saying, yeah. I don't like using any kind of additive. And the reason I don't is because what the additives give you is aged, or I should say old water. It gives you water that fish have been in for a long time. We tend to change water in order to overcome that. If you're putting chemicals like prime in order to somehow make the water healthier, then you're missing the fact that the healthiest water for fish is new water. Water that doesn't have dissolved solids in it or dissolved organics. Putting organics in the water, it seems to me, is while it, how do I want to say this? It's like an urban myth. It seems like a smart thing to do, but what you're really doing is creating an environment in which there's an excess of nutrients in the water for the sake of somehow making the water more comfortable for the fish. You don't replace the slime coat on a fish with supplements. The slime coat is not created externally. It's created internally. The fish actually exudes the slime. It doesn't somehow gather it from the water column. It's created by the cell structure in the fish. So it's a natural part of the fish's body. And that's going to be a function of food, of nutrition, rather than of supplement. I don't begin to understand how a non-food supplement could somehow adhere to a fish's body in order to enhance its slime coat. That just doesn't make sense to me. I've noticed that when fish are put in, Joey's talking about well water. I recommend well water straight out of the ground, given 15 minutes to oxygenate because it does not have dissolved oxygen in it. But that's really the only drawback from well water. It is natural, perfect water. It is the water the fish are living in at best. It is the very best water that nature has to provide. It's deeply filtered. It's perfectly clean. It contains dissolved minerals. It maintains a stable pH. It's absolutely healthy, perfect water that you do not need to add anything at all to. And the more you add to, the more trouble you're getting into. So I really don't buy the additive argument. I know people who do. I know people who do it successfully, and that's fine. Whatever their protocol is that's allowing them to do that is working for them. But I think for the average hobbyist who wants to keep dumping prime into a tank because they think it's healthy for the fish, they're not making the tank better by doing it. You know, they're creating an organic swill in the tank that has the potential to foul. So there's my flat earth take on additives.
Well, I realize how lucky I am with the well water at the house because of that one tank we have at the shop, and I'm on town water there, and I don't love it. So I understand the struggle for people.
Sharpies has a question.
With chlorine in the water.
Yeah.
Okay, then Sharpies is asking, he's saying perhaps things work as a minor irritant, which increases slime production.
Isn't that interesting? So they're trying to protect themselves from it. Now there's an interesting idea.
I don't know.
It's probably true. Probably true. Yeah. So yeah, you wanna make your fish healthier by fouling the water ever slightly. You know, put a little bit of something that's absolutely toxic in there. It'll make them stronger.
It's like those bullies in school. They're there for a reason.
Stronger, right?
Isn't there that saying, "What doesn't kill you makes you stronger"?
There it is. Right?
Yeah.
And haven't you ever gone out and whacked up your lilac tree and thrown a handful of lime and it blooms great the next year?
No.
Right. And then they bloom.
And then they bloom.
You got it.
I've noticed a lot of plants will bloom when they're near death. Well, I hope you found something you've never seen before. Have a great day. Thanks for sharing with us. Come on back.